Sexy, sexy ladies, hello! I see something I like on the beach, I gotta come express my feelings.
Charlie, don't boogie board!
Yeah. Back in the old days, you guys pull this shit, you get your asses beat.
Information about a pig rape scene in a book.
Here we go.
Oh, Jesus.
You ever read Old Yeller?
Oh!
Is it good?
It's all right. Do you know about the scene at the end where Travis has to kill his dog, Yeller? Do you know about that?
Yeah.
It's pretty moving.
Oh, no.
Right here. I stuck the muzzle of the gun against his head and pulled the trigger.
Oh my God.
And Old Yeller died.
No, that's sad.
It was an inspiration to me growing up, though.
Why?
Well, one Christmas, my cat Blinky started suffocating. So I wanted to be strong like Travis. I wordlessly retrieved my pellet gun and I shot Blinky in the head.
No.
Yeah. Turns out he was just coughing up a hairball.
Blinky.
Yeah, he didn't die, but he couldn't walk too straight after that.
Oh my God!
And poor Blinky. All right, you have a good day.
You too.
Any chance I can get your phone number?
Sorry.
Me too. Not with a human being, but. Excuse me, miss. Have you ever read this book, A Day No Pigs Would Die? It's a pig noise. To the best of my ability.
All right.
There's a scene in here where a pig rapes another pig. It's unbelievable.
Alright, man, you mean a creep, man? Like, that's...
What are you talking about?
I don't think she's comfortable, man. Just letting you know.
I'm just telling her about the book where the pig has sex with the other pig.
Rape, dude, made me uncomfortable.
Well, the pig rapes a pig. It's
Thank you.
It's swine on swine.
Swine on swine? What do you mean, swine on swine? What's swine?
Like, it's a... versus a...
Oh, so it's animal on animal rape?
It wasn't consensual, so.
Right. Well, let me read you a passage.
Now I'm curious.
Yeah, it goes like this. It goes.
Butting into Pinky's front shoulder with his snout, he half turned her about. Quick as silver, he jumped to her rear, pinning her up against the fence.
Now it was no longer a friendly visit. Now it was real business, and Samson seemed to guess what we all expected of him.
Up on his back legs, he came down hard upon her, his forelegs up on her shoulders. His privates were alert and ready to breed her.
He's raping the pig.
He's telling us about a raped animal. Yeah, that's very.
Well, I didn't write it.
The guy's not a bad writer.
Did you like the prose there?
I did. But at first I was thrown off because you said the word rape in front of a woman. And then now I'm just curious.
His entire back and body was thrusting again and again. And Pinky was squealing.
So what's your deal here?
I don't know. I skipped right ahead because I heard there was a pig rape scene in this.
Okay.
And I didn't expect to find myself here slightly aroused.
Well, you need to go find somebody else to be aroused with.
Do you want the book? I mean, I don't got a monopoly on the thing. You can buy it.
Yeah, what's it called?
It's called A Fucking Day When No Pigs Would Die.
Okay, man, you don't have to use that
it?
Language. Yeah, I'll buy it.
How much you got on you?
I mean, I'll get Venmo you probably.
You got Venmo right now?
Sounds interesting.
I start talking about pig rape and this guy comes out of the woodworks to buy the book. It's unbelievable. Promise me at least you'll get to your car before you start masturbating. All right, Venmo, pull out your phone.
What kind of books do you like to read, if not
you
pig
know
rape
what?
Ones?
I'm done talking to you.
Oh.
So you just move right on forward. You want me to go talk to the manager?
Yeah, if you want to, I'll come with you.
Okay.
Because they might appreciate the pig thing.
Let's do it.
Okay. Play your phone. Come here right now.
It's interesting.
All right. Thank you very
much. Hey, wait. Can you oversee the transaction? I need somebody neutral overseeing this guy's paying me.
I'll call him right now.
Let's see. Because this is the last copy. This is the only one on the shelves.
We have a gentleman in the store here that I think is maybe a little disturbed. Just kind of talking to patrons here and wants to read information about a pig rape scene in a book.
It's A Day No Pigs Would Die. I'm not going to call it a classic, but at least it deserves to be in posterity and still be in print.
What's your name, man?
Danny Mullen. $5.
All right, go ahead. I'll buy the book off you.
Oh, I'm sorry. She's a little bit of a prude, and I was just telling her A Catcher in the Rye was seen as obscene material in the 50s.
Everybody has the right to read whatever they want to read.
Uh-huh.
No censorship.
So I highlighted it. I highlighted the page where the pig gets raped.
All right.
It's a good fucking story. The guy's got real description when it comes to the pig putting his penis in the other pig.
Thank you.
No, it's okay.
Appreciate it.
Yeah. Thank you. Have you read Venus and Furs?
No.
It's 50 Shades of Grey about 150 years before 50 Shades of Grey. Have you read 50 Shades of Grey?
No.
I know you're not into romance, and I know it's 10:30 in the morning. You want to go grab a cocktail with me right now?
No. I'm okay.
No censorship for us, missus. None for us.
All right. So let's not end. Another guest, though.
What do you say you and I get out of here and go get good and drunk?
I can't. I'm married, and I'm not going out for cocktails, but thank you for asking.
I'm not married. I'm in a polyamorous relationship.
Okay.
With a man, a woman, and believe it or not, a pig.
Okay, well.
You read this book? The Heart of Darkness?
Heard of it. Yeah. I read it.
Disgusting. The
profit-motivated plundering of an entire continent, you know? European colonialism, yeah. mid-1800s. The blacks, though, they will work for cheap. My dad's actually a restaurant owner. He's got an Ethiopian dishwasher. I convinced him minimum wage was two rusty hubcaps I found on a bike trail. But still, I disagree with all this stuff. But in a modern context, yeah, one must make a buck, right?
All right, man. Thank you.
Cool. I thought you were kind of cute. It's actually the reason I wanted to come over and talk to you. Oh, no problem. If you need a hostess job at my dad's restaurant, they don't pay that well.
It's
but
all good, man. Thank you.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Sorry about it. Yeah. I'm sorry, man. Well, I'll get out of here.
This book fucking stinks, by the way. It's tedious. It's overwritten. It's overly academic. I like the movie adaptation, Apocalypse Now, about that Vietnam War. We're going to explore the movie.
We got some work to do. Uh-huh. If we're going to replicate Apocalypse Now, I need you guys on your game. You're going to be a little rusty, aren't you?
I think so. It's been a while.
What have you been doing this whole time?
Not much.
The valley. Shit. I'm still only in the valley. Every time I think I'm going to wake up on a filming mission. When Danny announced his break in December, it was worse. I hardly said a word to my girlfriend. Until she said yes to a third-string 49ers running back at a hotel party. When we were on the grind, I wanted to be on a break. Now that I'm on a break, all I can think of is getting back in the blue Mercury Danny's mom gave him. I've been here a month now, waiting for a mission, getting softer. Entire days slip by where I do nothing but request nudes from junior college students. Last week, I spent 5 hours in the mirror because an XL sweater I tried on at Gap fit a little snug.
You good?
What's it look like? You want a cigarette?
No, thank you, sir.
Have you ever met this gentleman? Know the general or myself?
No, sir, not personally.
Your reports specify you're a Danny Mullen main channel stalwart. And a podcast sidekick.
Sir, I'm not presently disposed to discuss such operations.
Did you not make out with a trashy girl in a lifeguard tower?
No, sir.
Did you not on July 5th blame some drunken firework horseplay on the Jews?
Sir, I am unaware of such activities, nor would I be disposed to discuss such activities, if in fact they did exist, sir.
I thought we'd have a bite to eat while we talk. Hope you brought an appetite.
Leo, you heard of Colonel Preston Inland Iggy Aguilar?
Yes, sir, I've heard the name.
This has been monitored from the Inland Empire. It's been verified as Colonel Aguilar's voice.
What? It don't matter.
at the end of the day, I'm getting more girls pregnant because my dick is bigger than Danny. Genetics say Danny's six and I'm seven.
Whoever gets to win gets fucking raped or gets fucking cred.
Colonel Aguilar was one of the finest crew members this channel ever produced. A humanitarian man. A man of humor. Of wit. But his methods have become unsound.
You stopped caring about shoots.
I'm definitely not doing that shoot with the cross. I'm already fucking tired.
Get up that hill!
I've already done enough today.
All you did was get naked once.
That's enough.
You do that all the time.
He blacked out and punched Danny in the face on Danny's birthday.
Obviously, he has gone insane.
Yes, sir. Very much so, sir. Obviously insane.
Your mission is to parody some famous scenes from Apocalypse Now. To terminate Colonel Aguilar's command.
Terminate? Inland Iggy.
Terminate with extreme prejudice. But first, take some R&R, Captain.
And to prove it, we're gonna give you some entertainment we know you're gonna like. Miss August, Miss Sandra Beatty.
Let's do this! A couple fresh-faced privates ready for action!
Let's go, girls.
Been flicking it, see if it's real.
So they call it, that's what they do. There's the booby trap, sir.
I'm just being honest. I'm a door gunner. This is what happens. I see something I like on the beach. I gotta come express my feelings in the printed word. A little shell-shocked. I don't know what's acceptable over here. Spent a lot of time in the jungle with these two assholes. Sexy, sexy ladies. Hello.
It's party time.
Excuse me, missus? Is your vagina named after a silent film star? Because I have orders to infiltrate and destroy Charlie. I was watching him train. Hey, your lead uppercut, it's nasty. Yeah. Nobody on this beach is gonna deny that. Right. One move though, him and I, fresh off a tour of duty in Nam, we picked up. Do you know about pulling the Bowie knife from your boot and sticking it up under a guy's lungs? It's not easy to pull off, but basically you pull a Bowie knife out of your boot and stick it up under a guy's lungs.
What's the get up with the sign?
Oh, we were just trying to get us a little pussy stateside, you know? Because pretty soon it's back to foxholes and shelling and stinky men named Private Abrams.
What happens when a small child sees it?
Well, they don't have big enough tits for me to be interested anyway, sir.
It's too risque.
Too risque?
What is too risque, sir?
Science?
What, have you seen your best friend's intestines blown across your face?
Yeah,
there's no such thing as risque. Being out here with all these people of color brings me back to my time overseas.
I remember that. How you doing, sir?
Sir, you're not gonna believe this, but in the heart of a Cambodian jungle, I sniffed pure cocaine out of a human pelvis.
It wasn't a big pelvis, it was a Vietnamese boy, so it was kind of smaller, yeah.
We let it dry out in the sun for 3 months. It was prepared for snorting. It was just as smooth as any mirror you use, sir. And the thing was, his family, they partook, because it's an honor in that country to have cocaine sniffed out of your eldest son's pelvis.
And it was the purest cocaine we've ever done.
Oh, sir, when I say hi for 48 hours, there isn't a speck of exaggeration in my eyes or soul.
I've probably never been the same after I snorted mine. From a pelvis?
You ever snorted the cocaine, sir? Straight out of the Cambodian wilderness? Makes the stuff we have over here look like Bisquick.
Oh, yeah. Good stuff, man.
And when we're over there, we've seen some stuff that would make the hair on your legs stand tent hut for hours.
I saw a pile of feet once.
A pile of feet. No explanation and no idea where it came from.
Yeah, it was just in the middle of the road, man.
It's stuff like that that you can't unsee. When you round a corner, after a 15-click hump through the jungle, you're expecting water, food, a friendly station,
but you see a pile of feet.
Sometimes at night, man, I see those feet walking towards me and it scares the shit out of me, man. I scream.
He has to have a bed lifted at least 6 inches off the ground because he's afraid there are gonna be disembodied feet underneath it otherwise. All right, sir. You're a good patriot.
Thank you, sir.
Keep studying.
Thank you for letting us talk to you today, sir.
This is a great country. Are you trying to be a citizen? What are you trying to do?
Salute, huh?
I'm a citizen.
You are a citizen? That's good. That's good. So we fought for your freedom, too.
Let's give him a good.
I have not fought for this country.
No, it's okay. We do the fighting.
We do the fighting.
You do the reading. You do the eating grapefruit on the beach. I'm not going to say we're three times the man you'll ever be,
but we're at least two.
That's correct.
You see a man's life leave his body after our knife enters it? Changes you. For the better sometimes.
So for sometimes for the better. When you see one of your best friends chained up behind enemy lines, and they're using his rib cage to hold a pet snake for the enemy battalion.
And he's still alive somehow.
Still
that's
alive. It was eating his liver for sustenance.
We put him out of his misery, if you're asking. Yeah, we had to shoot him.
And General Vi Dung of the North Vietnamese, he made a swing set for his daughter out of the severed arms of our best friends of the battalion.
The sickest man I've ever seen. You see a man like that, it's pure evil. I couldn't see anything in his eyes, man. That guy looked like it was dark, man. You looked in his eyes and it was gone.
It was nothing like a solar eclipse the Mayans would have recorded.
Exactly. Exactly like a solar eclipse.
It helps the Pange to talk it over sometimes. Really
thank you, it helps for us
guy.
To talk.
You're a really good
thank
guy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sir. Here's two places we can enter the river to find Iggy. Here, and here.
Mike, you know anything about this point?
It's a great peak.
Peak?
About 6 feet. It's got both the long right with the left slide. It's unbelievable. It's Tube City.
Why the hell didn't you tell me that before? There aren't any good peaks in this whole shitty country. It's all goddamn beach break.
It's really hairy in there, sir. Aggressive locals. It's Charlie's Point.
Charlie don't boogie board!
Paddle out! I'll catch that one switch! That's nothing! How's it going, brother? What's up, bud?
We're from Half Moon Bay. I'm Ray. This is my buddy Maze.
I'm Maze.
Is this fiberglass?
This is foam.
Yeah, there's an old Tahitian proverb. It's a man who stands on foam in the morning, sits on cock at night. Telling you though, bodyboarding, look into it. It's the purest form of wave riding. We're trying to help you do your job. We're trying to get all these surf pansies the fuck out of the water this morning. Yeah. You boogie board at all?
No.
Surf?
Yeah.
You got a problem with me now, son.
Yeah. Back in the old days, you guys pull this shit, you get your asses beat.
Where is everybody? A wetsuit? You don't need no fucking wetsuit, man. It's not that cold. Only one who needs a wetsuit is the chicks on the beach when they see me with this boogie board.
Yeah, you guys are classic.
That's where the soak comes in.
That's the best boogie board in America right here, man. That's Ray.
Let's see him do it.
Yeah. The first one hit a 360 crail grab on this bitch. In the future, this beach now is locals only. If we can't physically see your house, you're not welcome surfing in this beach anymore. The English, when they first sailed to Tahiti, where surfing was first discovered, the warrior men in the Tahitian tribes were boogie boarding, and surfing stand-up was reserved for menstruating teenage girls. Sir, your form was terrible out there. You're on the wrong kind of board, too. I'm paddling out just as you see me here, with the snorkel of the board.
And the shoes?
It's nice. I'm looking at sea life while I'm paddling out to the waves. You don't get that luxury, sir. You didn't plan ahead.
I did see a seal out there, so you guys are stoked.
It's going to be my friend. Absolutely. Oh. Right down the street, missus. There are a lot of posers out here today. A lot of guys from out of town. We're trying to shut it down. We don't like them on our beach.
Thank you.
No problem.
That's the reputation.
There's nothing worse than a poser, miss, and that's the one thing we don't tolerate. The only way to ride a wave is on your belly, kicking with your swim fins.
Sponging it?
Yeah.
What does it say? Your height?
Yeah. Hell yeah. But no, I'm serious, sir.
You went on and bought these things?
No.
You couldn't find any?
I'll leave it on there. It adds value if you leave the tag on there, so I leave my tag on there.
It's like the kid at your high school with a new era hat with a sticker on the bottom of the belt.
You guys don't boogie board up in Half Moon Bay?
Dude, the scene is booming up there.
Yeah, it is.
It's like California in the 50s up there, but for boogie boarders.
Mavericks and all that?
Oh, man.
Sponging the lefts at Mavericks?
You should see my crails.
The first guy to do a double butter on this.
Hey, I don't even know what a double butter means. Boogie boarders go over there.
No. The boogie boarders go over here.
The shipwreck is where the boogie boarders surf because it's a shorter, it's more of a wedgy wave. Down over here is more for the longboards and the stand-ups.
Let me make sure I'm understanding this correctly. Heterosexual men, homos. Ready for this, man?
Let's go. Let's fucking roll, baby.
I'm going in bare skin. I'll race you to the breakers, buddy. Let's do this. Up at Half Moon Bay, we call wetsuits body condoms. And you know what they say? You only need a condom if you're gay.
Let's go, Ray!
Adult swim, gentlemen. Adult swim now.
Be careful out there, man.
Yeah, a lot of bull sharks out there. They only go after surfers, though. You can surf your whole life, and you'll never be able to do what I just did.
It was like watching Baryshnikov ballet, dude. It was unreal.
I'm sorry to let anybody down if you were anticipating anything big, but I'm not a good enough writer, and we don't have a high enough budget to conclude this thing correctly. So, Leo's gonna wrestle Iggy on a lawn somewhere.
You guys want to see this? This is a matchup that's fresh.
Look at Leo, dude. Leo's training this like a title fight. Iggy drove all the way out from the Inland Empire just for this. This is a good place to do combat. Let's do it, Leo. No, let's do it. Stranger's law. You psyching him up, Ian? Ian, what kind of pep talk are you going to offer?
It's a classic David and Goliath. And who wanted David and Goliath? The Lord, I think. Sure.
Oh, God damn it. No. I think we should do it. Yeah, I agree with you. Let's go. They look like bandits.
Watch the corner. Watch the concrete.
Film. Babe. Yeah, film. Get over here. Get over here. Is it a thorn bush?
Finning.
Finish the joke, Leo. I don't like that they're dressed in black. It's first you to think they're going to get robbed. He tapped. Hey, good job, guys. Let's get the fuck out of here. Valiant fight from both men. Thanks for closing that out quickly before anybody came out with a shotgun. You guys are both dressed head to toe in black with long black hair. I would have blasted you and asked questions later.
Hey people, just wanted to request that you personally subscribe to this channel. I'm more motivated to make good stuff than ever. It's not gonna stop